तमिलनाडु टेरिटरी में, बी इट आरआरआर, पुष्पा और सीतारामम. शंकर सर, दिस वन्स फॉर यू, टॉकिंग अबाउट द बजट ऑफ दिस फिल्म, बिकॉज दैट इज समथिंग द एंटायर नेशन, द एंटायर वर्ल्ड हैज बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट सिंस द डे द मूवी वाज अनाउंस्ड. व्हाट डू यू हैव टू से सर, द प्रोडक्शन वैल्यूज, द बजट?
अदर प्रोड्यूसर इज सपोज टू प्रोड्यूस दिस मूवी, एंड व्हेन सुभाष सर केम टू नो दैट आई एम गोइंग टू डू दिस इंडियन टू for some other producer, he called me as a friend. I'm a good friend. I like this movie a lot. You should do for me only. So, no, with a lot of affection and friendship, he requested to do this film for him. So that is how it started. And I have a lot of imaginations, you know, like some imagination will be very big and some imagination will be very difficult to execute, and some imagination will be very expensive. And no, whatever, without the support of the producer, Mr. Subhash Karan, no, this film run out been possible, because I can dream, but my dream will be always a dream only. It won't come into reality unless such a lovely producer support for this movie.
Wow. Let's hear it for Laika Productions and Subhash sir, ladies and gentlemen. And yeah, ab jis pal ka intezar aap sab kar rahe the, I'm sure you have a lot of questions. So, kahan se?
Yes, you're right.
Hello, sir. This
Hello, sir.
Ravi sir, aata hoon main aapke paas. I'll quickly come to you.
Sir, mujhe Hindustani wala, matlab Hindustani, aaj bhi puri tarah se yaad hai. Jab pehli film release hui thi, kafi success hui thi, us waqt internet aur social media nahi tha. तो आज ये दोनों है, तो इसका असर आपकी फिल्म में कितना देखने को मिलेगा?
बहुत है, आप ट्रेलर में भी देखे होंगे. लॉट ऑफ इट इज देयर. एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट, ही पर्सोनिफाइज दैट इंटरनेट ईरा इन द फिल्म, एंड फ्यू मोर एक्टर्स, एबल एक्टर्स विद हिम, दे प्ले एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन द एक्सपोजिंग of not only corruption but of Hindustani, the hero itself.
Hello Kamal sir, this is Ravi Jain from ABP News. Towards your right sir. कमल सर, ये फिल्म 28 साल पहले आई थी. हम 70s 80s की मूवीज में भी देखते थे कि देखे है मैंने ऐसे कुछ मूवीज टीवी पर देखी है, तभी ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट, तब भी करप्शन की बात होती थी, सिस्टम को चेंज करने की बात की जाती थी. 28 साल पहले आपकी मूवी हिंदुस्तानी भी यही बात कर रही थी, और 28 साल बाद भी ज्यादा चीजें बदली नहीं है. आपको क्या लगता है कि व्हाई डोंट द थिंग्स चेंज एंड कुछ बदलाव कब आएगा?
सो क्या मैं नफरत कर रहा हूँ या शुक्रिया अदा कर रहा हूँ? What have we done? It is us. And the politicians are none other than one of the populace. We are all responsible for the corruption and we must all change our mind. And the best time to change our mind is during elections.
Very nice.
These are just reminders of how corrupt we have become. You told me about black and white era. Nothing has changed thanks to corruption. Everything will change thanks to the collective conscience. Thank you.
सर एक छोटा सा सवाल और कि आपने पिछले 50-60 सालों में हर तरह के किरदार निभाए हैं. पुष्पक की बात हो तो उसमें आपने एक साइलेंट किरदार निभाया था. नायकन की बात हो, मणिरत्नम की फिल्म, अप्पू राजा की बात हो, उस तरह के किरदार कभी किसी ने निभाए नहीं. आप सब कुछ कर चुके हैं. मैं जानना चाहूंगा कि इन टर्म्स ऑफ सिनेमैटिक अचीवमेंट और ऐसी क्या चीज आप करना चाहेंगे, क्योंकि आज की तारीख में भी आप उतने ही इन्वॉल्व है सिनेमा मेकिंग में.
After so many years in the cinema, allowing me to do another film itself is a great thing. Thank you all. So I think every time I surprise myself, I live a dream. So dream mein kabhi udte hain, kabhi marte hain, kabhi we become something else. I've become all that thanks to you, and I'm continuing to do that. The next opportunity I get to perform before you is a miracle for me.
My question is same.
Kamal sir here. Kamal sir and Shankar sir.
Okay, just a sec. Piyush sir wants to say something.
I was sleeping.
And I was shooting this film with you on the set. I asked you a question, still the same question arrives. How did you write Thavar Magan? That is the best adaptation of Godfather in any language of the world.
Partly by pen. Partly by experience. I come from that kind of place. I belong to a small village called Paramakudi. So that taught me a lot. And my gurus like Mr. K. Balachandar and other great writers in not only Tamil Nadu but in North. I'm a great fan of Mr. K. A. Asif. And they taught me how to hold this uncontrollable horse called cinema and yet have a good ride.
Jinko sawal sunai nahi diya hoga, Piyush sir said, how did you write Thevar Magan? Thevar Magan. Those of you who don't know this film, please Google kijega, Thevar Magan, Thevar Magan. It is one of the greatest films ever made in this country and Piyush Mishra sahab ke bol agar main chura lu to it's the best adaptation of Godfather in any language. And that is written by Kamal sir and he's also the lead actor in the film. So please, I would really request you to watch that film also. But you've seen Virasat. Virasat ka original Thevar Magan hai, uski baat chal rahi hai.
So, I wanted to do it only with Yusuf sahab. When he said, I'm not going to do any more films, then I sold the rights to somebody because I didn't want, couldn't think of anybody else. Because while I knew I was doing it with the greatest actor, I knew when I was born in Tamil Nadu, Shivaji sahab. And through him, he translated Yusuf sahab for me. I could understand that acting transcends language. And so that was a dream that didn't come through, but somebody else made it and made it very well. It became a success. So that to explain my film, he just has to say Virasat. I thank those filmmakers, he's also a friend of mine, for doing that so well that people will remember the address of my film through that film.
Come on,
and sir, how I wrote the film is I was thinking of Shivaji sahab. I was thinking of my native place. I was thinking of myself. And things just happened. I wrote it in 7 days.
Wow. Kamal sir and Shankar sir on your left. Kamal sir and Shankar sir on your left. Here. Simran Singh. Here. Sir. Here. Hello sir. Kamal sir here. Forever. So, मेरा सब दो सवाल है. पहला एक छोटा सवाल ये है कि जैसे हम अगर इंडियन की बात करें, सो व्हाट विल बी द एज ऑफ सेनापति? बिकॉज आई रिमेंबर कृष्णा स्वामी जब इंडियन में देयर इज अ सीन वेयर यू नो ही लुक्स इनटू द बायोडेटा ऑफ सेनापति, सो हिज बर्थ ईयर वाज 1918. तो अगर उस हिसाब से बात करें, सो ही इज 106 इयर्स ओल्ड. सो आप उसमें पहले तो क्लैरिटी दीजिए. ये
पहला सवाल. आई डोंट नो दैट एज हैज टू बी डिटरमाइंड बाय हिम. आई वुड लाइक टू एक्ट इवन व्हेन आई एम 120.
मार्शल आर्ट्स मास्टर इन चाइना, हिज नेम इज लूसी जियांग. एट द एज ऑफ 120 इज परफॉर्मिंग द मार्शल आर्ट्स, इज फ्लाइंग, इज किकिंग एंड ऑल लाइक. सो दिस सेनापति कैरेक्टर इज ऑल्सो इज अ मास्टर. A master in martial arts, ancient martial arts called Varma art. So this master will have a discipline in food, in habits like yoga, meditation, and only one time food and all, no, they take. So if you are a master in your craft and the discipline in your behavior, no, the age doesn't matter. They can perform any kind of stunts.
Wow. Okay.
Oh, your question. I have seen Gojei Yamaguchi, the sixth Dan of Budokai in Chennai when he was 89. So it's possible, but that's the only example I could think of.
Ji.
So I don't know the Chinese gentleman.
Ji, I have another question for you, both of you. Iski journey, sir, film ki journey jo rahi hai, kafi, matlab, it's been a difficult journey as well. Matlab, ek to 28 saal baad aa raha hai, but you started pre-COVID, then there was COVID, and there was two waves of COVID, kuch ek incident bhi hua tha aapke yahan pe. So, ye sab hata ke then this film is coming. So how do you look upon to the journey? It's been quite a tough journey and inspiring on the same level.
I think we all will have to share the answer.
Please.
When somebody was asking about a budget, the budget was not just decided by the director and the script. COVID decided our budget. Some of the accidents delayed and increased the budget. The tenacity of purpose of both the director and the producer has to be applauded even before the film becomes a hit. That I owe to them. So this is that applause for them. Because it's very easy to let go. Haath dukh raha hai, so let me leave this and go to another one. They didn't do that. Because all of us were working, we had other films to do. And even he had other films. But not to let go of this child, not to orphan this child, was a decision taken by Laika Productions and Mr. Shankar.
After so many years, what changes do you see in him as an actor now?
See, experience. And the main thing is is updated acting. That is very important. Like once the actors become senior, keep on doing the roles and all that, they may become repetitive. And after a period of time, it may get bored for the audience to see their performance. Okay. So, I'm seeing Kamal sir, today, all his performance very updated. So that is a special thing I've seen in his performance.
But I'll have to say something different about Mr. Shankar. The Shankar that should be today, with all the experience I have seen in the first film, he was very confident. As a matter of fact, I was not too willing to do the movie because I had another story very similar. I said, actors have this problem. I want to do this movie, not this one and all that. I had that problem also. I want to do it again with Shivaji sir. But he never budged. Then I raised my money. The producer didn't move. He kept negative because the director said, if I make the film, I'll make it only with this gentleman. And he was confident like a very savvy, seasoned director. That I was surprised about. The same cool, calm start and cut I hear even today. That's astounding.
Kamal sir, how do you define Pan-India film? How do you define a Pan-India film?
You define it.
How the audience defines it.
When all of India appreciates a film, it becomes Pan-India film. Just make films. Satyajit Ray Saab didn't make Pan-India films. He made Bengali films. We made it international. The world made it international. So also that what do I know about Mughalyazam? What do I know about Shambhanagal Saab Ankur? I understood it. We made it Pan-Indian film. I made it Pan-Indian. As a fan, we all went and saw it, our jaw dropped, and we adopted that film. It became a Pan-Indian film. You are the magic to make a film Pan-Indian. India is the magic.
Sir?
Hi.
You left.
Can I ask?
Here, you left. Come on, sir. To your left.
Who's asking?
Ask, sir.
Well, who?
Yeah.
Somebody is dubbing for you. One minute.
That's going to be a bad dubbing. So you have been the encyclopedia. So, yeah. Like Atli sir said, you have been the encyclopedia of cinema. Be it any cinema. In Indian, okay, but when it comes to the Hindi cinema, you have given so many movies, and today it's like the 32 years completion of SRK, and you have directed him, a superstar, and you have directed him. And you know, I want to know how was the experience there and what is the difference that you see in him.
No, I can't hear the question. You could be here.
Says he remembers you directing a superstar like SRK and he wants to know. He's made the interview about SRK. This is a question about SRK. So he says he wants to know the difference you see in him since the day you directed him till now, because it's 32 years of
Let me talk Shah. On behalf of Mr. SRK, because I'm sure that he'll allow me to do that. When we work together, we are all just people. I don't see a superstar, he doesn't see a super director, doesn't see we are friends. As a matter of fact, Shah Rukh Saab made that film for free. Yeah. And what more do you need? That cannot be done by a superstar. That can be done only by a fan, a connoisseur of art, and a good actor.
Right.
I'm ever thankful for him. So we don't see all that. Later on, you give us those titles, and we very shyly accept it. Thank you.
Mayuria, sir, to your left, please, Kamal, sir.
Sir, my second question to Siddharth. Here. You know, you said that you learned so much from Kamal, sir. But there is something that kind of intrigues me. It's like, what is one thing that you would like to take from him, you know, like,
as qualities would you like to adopt from him?
No, I'd like to answer this with respect to both of my teachers, kyunki Shankar sir, jinko sabko pata hai, lekin every film he does is at a scale jo mamuli logon ke bas ki baat nahi hoti utna sochna. Samajh rahe ho? Hindi cinema has seen some incredible masters of grandeur and craft like K. Asif Saab and all the way up to Sanjay Leela Bhansali sir, who do spectacle where every frame, yaar, ek frame create karne ke liye ek din lagta hai. You know, so Shankar sir has been doing that since his first film, and every film of Shankar sir's is what, like he describes, it's an impossible dream, and it's him and the people who believe in him that take it up a mountain and they become forever. So Shankar sir today also directs, imagines, eats and sleeps and dreams cinema the same way. Like, I've worked with him for 21 years. I've seen him 21 years apart, and Shankar sir is still the weaver of impossible dreams. I call him the merchant of dreams of Indian cinema, because he thinks and dreams in ways that will give all of us sleepless nights, because it's so expansive. And we were shooting Dada Arare song, and every day the setups he would make me feel like I was in a dream dancing in that song, because to set up every shot it takes 1,200 people and I have to dance in the middle of it. And I asked him, how do you do this every day? And he was shooting another film parallelly, huh? And he doesn't know, I always keep spying on him and seeing what he's doing on all his sets. He was shooting with 2,000 people in another state for another film one day before, and then he's come here at 4:30 in the morning and he's setting up 1,500 people in a shot. And he says, I only know how to make films like this. And I believe him, because that's the dreams that he works with. So Shankar sir is the same. He always dreams the impossible dream. Aur rahi Kamal sir ki baat, the what I took away from him, Kamal sir ko maine 20 saal se, main jo bhi interview mein koi bhi akalmandi ki baat karu na, wo aap agar thoda google karoge to mere se pehle unhone bola hoga, to main bas chep raha hu usko, theek hai na? To main bahut wo copy paste kar raha tha. तो उस टाइम मैंने कहा था मुझे स्टार नहीं बनना, मुझे एक्टर बनना है. तो उन्होंने कहा ऐसा क्यों? तो मैंने कहा बस मुझे ऐसे लगता है. तो ये मैं 20 साल पहले के इंटरव्यू की बात कर रहा हूँ. तो मुझे कमल सर ने सिखाया था कि सबसे पहले मेरा काम है एक एक्टर बनना, ना कि एक स्टार बनना या एक हीरो कहलाना. क्योंकि एक्टर का काम वो होता है जो लेखक उसके लिए लिखता है और डायरेक्टर उससे कराता है, और अगर वो लोग चाहें तो ये तालियां बजेंगी, लेकिन मैं तालियों के लिए भीख नहीं मांगता और पहले 5 मिनट में उसको एक्सपेक्ट भी नहीं करता. तो ये मैंने कमल सर से सीखा है. और सेट पे जो काम चलता था, मैं कमल हासन के सामने खड़ा हूँ और मेरी डायलॉग, एक पेज के डायलॉग दिए गए मुझे, मैं बोल रहा हूँ सर एक सेकंड, मैं जाके सीधा गया डायरेक्टर के पास, सर मेरे सामने कमल हासन एक्ट कर रहा है सर, मैं बोल रहा हूँ उसके, तो सोच मेरे पे क्या बीत रही होगी, तो चल जाके एक्ट कर वहां पे. सो इट वॉज सो एक्साइटिंग फॉर अस टू सी हिम बिहेव लाइक अ चाइल्ड. ही वर्क्स लाइक अ फर्स्ट टाइमर इन एवरी शॉट, एंड ही डज. सब लोग सोचते हैं ना कमल हासन सेट पे है तो वही सब कुछ करते होंगे, वही सब कुछ, प्रोड्यूसर भी वही है, डायरेक्टर भी वही है, वही गाना गा देंगे, वही नाच देंगे, वही सब कुछ कर देंगे. वैसे उनमें काबिलियत है, वो कर सकते हैं, लेकिन वो क्या करते हैं, वो ऐसे बस जाके डायरेक्टर के सामने पूरा, उनका बॉडी लैंग्वेज थोड़ा सबमिशन का होता है, बोलिए, और वो सुनते हैं ऐसे, और पूरा सुन के ठीक है, इतना ही होता है उनका, और बाकी सब इंटरनल है.
और वो अपने आप को याद दिलाते रहते हैं कि वो उतने पहुंचे हुए आदमी नहीं है, वो बहुत मॉडेस्टी और ह्यूमिलिटी दिखाते हैं. तो दैट्स व्हाट आई टेक फ्रॉम हिम कि आपको जितना भी मालूम हो, जब आप काम पूरी मतलब आप वो क्या बोलते हैं प्योरिटी के साथ करते हैं ना, आपको ये पहले महसूस होता है कि मुझे कुछ नहीं पता और मैं आज सीखूंगा. तो वो आज भी रोज सीखते हैं और वो मेरे को रात के 11 बजे फोन करके बोलेंगे तुमने ये बुक पढ़ी है? मैंने कहा मैं तो सो रहा था. तुमने ये बुक पढ़ो? ठीक है सर मैं पढ़ता हूँ. अभी पढ़ते रहते हैं, फिल्में देखते रहते हैं. ही इज अ यूनिवर्सिटी, ही इज अ वॉकिंग टॉकिंग यू नो यूनिवर्सिटी. सो दैट्स व्हाट आई लर्न फ्रॉम हिम, दैट एवरी डे बी अ स्टूडेंट. That's why he still says, मैं कैसे गुरु कहला सकता हूँ? वो अभी भी अपने आप को विद्यार्थी समझते हो, ठीक है ना? So that is Kamal sir, and that's what I've learned from him.
Hi, I have one light question, one for Kamal sir and one for Siddharth. And when I talk about Hindustani and it's a cult film, and my most cherished memory is this song Telephone Dhun Mein. But you know, cinema can have a profound effect on someone. And for the 28 years, you know, I've been trying to figure out. How does you know telephone dhun mein hasne wali ya hasne wala, how would if someone try to enact that in the real life, how would that telephone dhun wali laugh
sir sound? Mujhe laga ye kahani kahan khatam hogi, main bataun aapko. maine socha aapko ek ladki mili jo telephone dhun mein hasti hai aur aap dono shaadi karke abhi bahut khush hain. Mujhe laga ye kahani wahan jaake khatam hogi, lekin wo puch rahe hain ki ek hota kaise. Sir, how does a girl laugh like a telephone melody? Sir, you only created this, that's what he wants to know.
I like Kamal sir first, if he can.
No, actually, the person to be blamed is Mr. Vairamuthu, who created that line. And since Hindustani was dubbed in Hindi, they just picked up that line. It's a very complicated line. What the original poet was trying to say is that when you laugh, it feels like a telephone is ringing. He sort of confused with the B. LLE and BELL.
Hi, Kamal and sir. Siddharth, I think looking at the trailer and you know, even Kamal sir mentioned about social media, and from whatever I've read online about your character, I think he's called Varadar Rajan. And it was written that you play this character and you make social media videos exposing corrupt politicians.
देखिए इंडियन टू या हिंदुस्तानी टू की कहानी तो मतलब 28 साल से लोग लिख रहे हैं और पिछले 5 सालों से बहुत से लोग बहुत से थ्योरीज लेके घूम रहे हैं. मैं भी रोज पढ़ता हूँ, तो उसमें मुझे भी जो मैंने फिल्म में किया है वो तो आप देखेंगे जुलाई 12 को, लेकिन जो मैंने नहीं किया और लोग अपना इमेजिनेशन से सोच रहे हैं, मुझे सुनने में तो बड़ा अच्छा लग रहा है यार कि मैंने इतने सारे आइडियाज को इंस्पायर किया इस कैरेक्टर से. बट वॉट एवर द ट्रेलर टेल्स यू, जितना सर ने आपको बताना था वो उन्होंने बता दिया है. उसका क्रॉस क्वेश्चनिंग में जवाब देने की मतलब जिम्मा मैं नहीं ले सकता क्योंकि मैंने लिखा नहीं है. सो यू विल सी ऑल ऑफ दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्लॉट पॉइंट्स दैट विल बी इन द फिल्म व्हेन यू सी इट.
सो द मीडिया रिपोर्ट से दैट इंडियन 2 वाज टू लॉन्ग एज अ फिल्म, सो इट हैड टू बी यू नो स्प्लिट इन टू पार्ट्स, व्हिच मींस इंडियन 3 इज रेडी. सो वुड यू लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट दैट प्रोसेस?
सी दैट्स अ choice of the director. I will talk for myself. When I made Vishwaroop, we read the script. It was 350 pages long. They said, you edit it, it'll make a fantastic film. On day one in Vishwaroop, I was shooting for Vishwaroop Part 2. Because I'd made the decision, I've told my crew that this is going to be in two parts. We embark on a journey today to make 2 films. You'll be paid as such. But I'll be shooting sporadically back and forth between 2 films. But I'll explain the story to you. All of us had a reading and they'll remember that, all the actors in that film. And that's the kind of decision that Mr. Shankar has made. I'm very sure we would have given him hell and said, no, let's make one film. That was there in his mind. And above all, like I was ready to do that. There are many competent directors who are waiting for the right producer to make one film. He got the opportunity to make 2. Why not use it? That's what he must have thought. That's what I think.
Yeah.
I would like to explain, because the part one, as I told before, it only revolves around one state. That part one itself is 3 hours 20 minutes film. Now the story spreads all over the country to all the states, so naturally the story become big. Actually, our initial idea is to do only one part. After start filming and when I sit in the editing room, all the scenes from my part of it came out very well. If for the sake of you have to make it in one part, if I compress the whole thing, the soul of each and every scene, the feel of every scene would have been lost. So I was thinking like, so all the scenes are looking good and it's not boring, and I'm able to see there is a two parts in that story, and each part has its own strength and whole form and engaging scenes and a start, a body and a climax and a finish. So it evolved automatically in two parts.
Sir, COVID jaisi bimari ko suljhate suljhate 3 saal lag gaye na. Corruption naam ki bimari hai. Kam se kam 2 aur picture lagenge.
Hi, this is Komal Panchal from Indian Express. So my question is for Kamal sir and Shankar sir actually. When Indian came out, in 2006-2007, it gave a kind...
96, ma'am.
Sorry, 96, I mean, so many years ago, I was just 10 years old, I remember. And...
Thank you for reducing our age.
Yeah. So, you know, it kind of gave that power to the masses to ask questions. Yeah, it people thought that if there is corruption, they can ask questions, and there is someone like Senapati in us who can ask these questions, who can act against corruption. Today, in this political scenario, how easy or difficult is it to make a film like that? And in the trailer also, we say, you know, that why not just flag someone as an anti-national when someone is asking questions, and that happens a lot today. So how do you all navigate through this scenario, the situation today, and how easy or difficult is it to make a film that questions the establishment?
Navigate what, ma'am?
How do you all then make a film that questions establishment?
No, that's been a problem since the time of the British, and people were making films even then. We will continue to make those kind of films. It doesn't matter who's at the top of the establishment. That's the not just a filmmaker, that's a citizen's right to ask those questions. And we as artists, since we represent so many people, thanks to the applause, we believe that we are your representatives. Hence we talk boldly without thinking of the guillotine.
But very few.
Yes, there is a risk. The government can become angry, but your applause puts out that fire.
Yeah. Very few actors do that, right?
So make it louder.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll take two more questions, okay?
सिद्धार्थ एंड कमल सर, आप दोनों के लिए मेरा सवाल है, जो हिंदुस्तानी 2 का टैगलाइन है जीरो टॉलरेंस, तो देश और समाज से जुड़े ऐसे कौन से मुद्दे हैं जिसके प्रति आप दोनों जीरो टॉलरेंस रखते हैं, एंड कौन सी ऐसी चीजें जिसे दिल पर पत्थर रख करके टॉलरेट करना पड़ता है?
What are the issues in your life that you maintain a zero tolerance stand, and where are the ones you'll say, okay, I have to adjust and tolerate?
I'm a great fan of Gandhiji. They say he taught you tolerance. What do you think about tolerance? I said, I'm not a great fan of the tolerance business. Gandhiji is my hero. But who do you tolerate? Not a friend. So I want friendship to grow in this world. What you tolerate is a headache. So I don't think, but anything that's a headache for the society, you must have zero tolerance for. Find a medicine, put it out. And that's what I think.
हेलो कमल सर,
एक मिनट रुक
सवाल कमल जी से
है। अबे भाई रुक ना,
जवाब माय पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। Zero tolerance means you would have seen the part one. This Senapati character, no? He can't take anything wrong. So, he will kill his corrupt son. That is zero tolerance. Okay, that kind of character is Senapati. Even he can't forgive his own son if he's doing something wrong.
So, मेरा सवाल वही था चंद्रु को लेकर के, वो आपने आंसर पहले ही दे दिया. मेरा सवाल ये था कि जब भी कोई भ्रष्टाचार के विरुद्ध लड़ाई लड़ने निकलता है, if somebody is fighting against the corruption and the corruption is within his family, the supreme sacrifice that Senapati gives is to kill his son in the first movie. So how ready we are to have a Bhagat Singh and Mahatma Gandhi or a Senapati in our own home?
Okay, then I suggest, I prescribe Indian 2 for you to see.
आपके सवाल का जवाब फिल्म में है सर, ये 100% गारंटी है. और मैंने भगत सिंह का किरदार निभा लिया है, सेनापति के बाजू वाला किरदार निभा लिया है, तो मैं थोड़ी बहुत चीजें सीख के जा रहा हूँ. तो जो सवाल आप पूछ रहे हो, मैं भी उसका जवाब इस फिल्म में आपके साथ ढूंढूंगा.
बाकी 12 जुलाई को बहुत कुछ देखने को मिलेगा सिनेमा घर में. जी आखिरी सवाल ले रहे हैं वहां से.
हेलो कमल सर, दिस इज विनय सर. इतनी बड़ी पर्सनालिटी होने के बाद, इतना फेमस होने के बाद, आपने काफी बड़ी पिक्चरें दी हैं, तो लोग आपको इंस्पिरेशन मानते हैं, तो आप अपने आगे के नेक्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट किस तरह से, क्या सोच के आप सिलेक्ट करते हो कि वो इमेज बरकरार रहे, कुछ गलत इफेक्ट ना पड़े?
You are talking about a big personality. You are not the man who is seeing my image in my toilet. I do. He is not a big man. He is yet to become a big man. And I am working on it. So,
okay, that's all we have for you, ladies and gentlemen. 12th July is when we'll get to see the movie in theaters, Hindustani 2.